Hello and welcome to Ivan Stewart's Super Off-Road Racer. Now, this was a conversion from the arcades and was converted, I think, to all the systems back then by Graphgold. They normally make pretty good games, so let's have a look. They can have up to three players in this game, so it's quite good fun with your friends, I suppose, but I'm here all my own, so just need to test it as a one-player game. As you can see, it's obviously based on a derivative of Super Sprint, or that sort of arcade game, or even Grand Prix on the is it Grand Prix, I think, on the Atari 2600. There's a little bit of perspective in this. Amazing graphics, a little bit more interesting, I think. And it's, of course, off-road, so the car sort of rough and tumble, sort of bounces all over the place, which is okay. It makes it a bit more interesting, actually. And you can buy suspension power-ups to make it a bit less jumpy. And of course you press fire to activate your nitro, but you've only got a limited amount. I've got 16 left at the top there, you can see. I mean, these sort of games are, you know, this sort of genre, you can take or leave it. If you don't like this genre, this isn't going to change your mind. I quite like these sort of games, to be honest. So I could buy some wheels, makes me turn quicker, I think. Buy some suspension. Then you buy some engine power-ups, make cargo faster or accelerate faster. I think the music's actually quite good, though. It's quite sort of Jigsaw Hazard sounding. Come on, out the way. The graphics are actually quite smart, I think. Some little cars are quite well drawn. There's just enough detail on them to, make them recognisable. I'm not that big a fan of the coin-op, to be honest. I always find it a little difficult to play, but not too much fun, but this conversion is actually quite good fun, I think. Like all these sort of games, it doesn't take long to sort of get fed up with them. You eventually get to a stage where the opponent's cars become competitive enough that you can't really make much further progress in the game. Now, interestingly enough, you've got two credits here, but you can trade them in for more money if you want to upgrade your car earlier. I suppose it's a strategy that might work if you know what you're doing, but most of the time I don't really. Now, one of the benefits of this, certainly the 64 version has, that it's not multi-load, it's all in one load, so that's nicely done. But then again, I'm sure there's not as many tracks as there are in the coin-op, but I could be wrong about that. If somebody knows, you can always leave a comment. But it doesn't seem that many tracks on this version anyway. And all that happens is that the game just mirrors. Instead of going clockwise, you go anti-clockwise. The graphics don't really change, it's pretty much consistent, just mostly brown. Yep, so, okay, that's I'm Stuart's Super Off-Road Racer for you. It's probably not 100% accurate as a conversion, but it's fairly Northern Lights quite representative of the coin-op. In my opinion, it's actually more fun than the coin-op. I feel like this sort of game was recommended. I'll give this 7.5 out of 10, I think, because it's quite well done. Quite good fun for a while. Probably more fun with one or two other players, but just not bad at all. Right, that's all for this video. See you in the next one.